Hello, firearms friends. Joel Colander with Rock Island Auction Company. Thanks for tuning in for another video of fantastic firearms. Of course, this series of videos, we are talking about firearms in our upcoming May premiere auction. That's May 3rd, 4th, and 5th of 2019. And with me today is Greg. Everybody say hi to Greg. Greg is one of our describers here at Rock Island Auction Company. And for those that don't know, that means whenever you see in the catalog the description or condition statement, Greg is part of the team that puts all those together. It gives him a very hands-on, more hands-on probably than most folks in the building, perspective about some interesting guns in the auction. And you've picked out three today.
I have. I've picked out three shotguns that during the course of writing descriptions for the May auction just stood out to me. Now these are three shotguns by a Harry McKay of Warrenton, Missouri. Now, a lot of people are going to ask, who is Harry McKay? Why is this important? It's important because it speaks to a tradition in American gunsmithing, where you have an individual with the right tools, the right materials, and the know-how to be able to say, that's good, now I want to try it. Mm-hmm. And that's exactly what McKay did. McKay, he's kind of one of those trap range ghost stories. You try to research and you always end up with one or two old boys saying, oh yeah, I knew Harry back in the 60s or in the early 70s. He made great competition trap guns. And we hear he may have made an over-under or two. And we actually have one of those over-unders right here. We don't have an exact number on how many guns he made. It's estimated somewhere in the area 15 to 20. Less on the over-unders. But first, what we have here, it's a very, very nice single barrel trap style shotgun. As you can see, the barrel is engraved in gold inlaid, H.M. McKay, Harry McKay. And just wonderful engraving going on here. And it's a very classic style engraving. It's scroll, nice swirling scroll, and then gold inlaid bird scenes.
And a lot of other great trap features people look for. We have the long barrel, we have a nice fat forend, the matte rib, and yeah, not just the gold on the initials, it was with the maker's name, but all over in these sort of nice panel scenes with some wild game on it.
And then, I mean, if you also look at the underside, thank you, you can see that this is, the model is there, it's a Monomac. And this is number 12, so.
With more gold underneath on the grip cap and a little, looks like a little woodcock there. And
yep, I mean, engraving on the forearm fittings, just a lot of workmanship went into all of these pieces.
It is a beautiful shotgun, especially considering for essentially a home gunsmith.
Exactly.
Well, what else do we have here?
These are the two McKays that just really, really caught my eye and kind of captured my imagination. These are both, again, Harry McKay shotguns. As you can see, obviously, an over-under, and again, another single barrel like a trap gun. The over-under, I mean, the wood, the really nice dark figuring on the wood, absolutely wonderful. And you'll see that this, it has a sliding standard top lever and the sliding section here, like a Krieghoff K32 or a Remington Model 32. And again, this is a guy in Missouri doing these. And again, just great engraving, classic swirling scroll, wedges on the barrels, and again, more gold inlay. And probably my favorite kind of gold inlay. Just simple, subtle, and just there to make it pop. And you see here on the barrel, special made for Graves Gladney by Harry M. McKay, Warrenton, Missouri. Graves Gladney, his story is as interesting as these guns themselves. For all of the work in these guns, the Gladney story is amazing. Born St. Louis, Missouri, was an accomplished trap shooter, so they say. Then he went to art school in London. After art school, he came back to the United States and became an illustrator and a painter, professor of fine arts at Washington University in St. Louis. And from there, he went on for at least 2 years to paint every cover of one of America's most famous and longest lasting pulp magazines, The Shadow.
Huh.
So this, the man that had this gun and this gun is responsible for what most people think of when they hear The Shadow. Just iconic covers over a span of 2 years, over 70 covers in that time period. Each one a painting. I mean, each one hand painted, and the story gets better. At the outbreak of World War II, Gladney was drafted, as were just about anybody else. He went to be a gunnery instructor, again, because they say he was a very good shot. Mm-hmm. And he did that for a while. Then he transferred. He wanted action. Transferred to the 82nd Airborne.
Is that all?
Yeah, only. So with the 82nd Airborne, according to the stories I was able to find on this individual, he went to Normandy and Market Garden. A lot of soldiers did both. Not a lot of soldiers did both in gliders.
Or lived to tell the tale.
Exactly. Survived the war, which in 1945, as a first lieutenant, led his combat division into Berlin. So the guy did it all. I mean, he's been there, seen that, and probably had a painting or two about it.
I mean, he was literally on the front lines from
exactly.
Like America's involvement in the European theater.
Yeah. I mean, he was right there. He's, like I said, he's been there, he's seen it. And I think these guns, they're incredibly interesting to me because of the way they connect to someone that was himself so interesting.
Mm-hmm.
And then you combine that with, again, that American spirit of gunsmithing, of right skills, right materials, and then putting it all together in a piece like these. And this one, the over-under is actually, it's Neil Hartleep engraved. Neil Hartleep, one of my favorite engravers, Iowa native. And he'd actually engraved guns for people such as Buddy Hackett and William F. Cody Jr. So again, you're combining a lot of elements that for me are just top list. Great gold work, great scroll, and an amazing story.
And great high-end features. I mean,
oh, yeah.
from the engraving, it should be no mystery with engraving like this, but you know, from the release on these break actions to, like we mentioned before, matted ribs to ventilated handguards to the drops to the beautiful figuring on the wood that you mentioned earlier. These are clearly high-end machines.
Absolutely.
And friends, the May 3rd, 4th, and 5th premier auction is full of outstanding sporting arms just like these. Make sure you check out the full listings on rockislandauction.com. There's going to be roughly 2,700 collector firearms available with an excellent search feature so you can find the guns that you're looking for. Thanks for watching and tune in to the next video with Rock Island Auction Company.